हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू ऑल ऑफ यू। इन दिस वीडियो लेक्चर वी आर गोइंग टू कमेंस ए न्यू टॉपिक दैट इज मॉडर्न पीरियडिक टेबल एंड इन विच वी हैव टू स्टडी मॉडर्न पीरियडिक लॉ एंड One more thing. Before studying this point, I would like to remind you that what is the need of this modern periodic table and what is modern periodic law. So, as you are knowing, first of all, for the study of elements or for the arrangement of elements, a table was provided by Dmitri Mendeleev, who was a Russian chemist, and that table was based on the principle of atomic mass. Means, according to Mendeleev's periodic law, the elements were arranged in the increasing order of atomic mass, and the statement was the physical and the chemical properties of the elements are periodic function of their atomic masses. Means that the elements which were known at that time were arranged properly in different rows and vertical columns in order of increasing atomic masses. But due to some anomalies, that Mendeleev periodic table was cancelled, and I would like to once again remind you some of the anomalies or some of the demerits of Mendeleev periodic table. That is, this table, Mendeleev periodic table, was unable to explain the position of hydrogen element. Means position of hydrogen element was still undefined. Similarly, position of isotopes, about the position of isotopes, no information was given in the Mendeleev periodic table. Similarly, in Mendeleev periodic table, some of the anomalous pair of elements were present. Means that the elements which having higher atomic massage were placed before the lower atomic massage elements. A simplest example of this kind you are knowing, that is potassium and argon. So argon atomic mass is 40 and potassium is 39. So according to the increasing order of atomic mass, potassium should be the first before argon, right? But it was not as such. Argon was first, then potassium, means 40, then 39. And such type of many drawbacks were. Similarly, in the case of cobalt and nickel, and similarly in the case of tellurium and iodine. So due to this type of anomalies, this table was cancelled. And some more demerits of the table was, that is, the similar elements were placed in different groups, like copper and mercury, at least showing similar property but placed in a different group. Likewise, lead and barium having at least similar property but they were placed in different groups. So the elements having similar property were placed in different groups. That was also the biggest drawback of Mendeleev periodic table. Similarly, dissimilar elements having placed in the same group. In Mendeleev periodic table, the dissimilar elements were placed in the same group, and one more drawback you can say that there was no well defined about the eighth group element. There was no appropriate information or no well defined about the eighth group element which was given according to Mendeleev periodic table. In Mendeleev periodic table, you are knowing that elements were arranged in a groups, and these groups were divided in a subgroup A and subgroup B. And after subgroup A, subgroup B, there was an eighth group also, and eighth group was divided in a three vertical columns, and they were commonly known as eighth group elements. All right, like iron, cobalt, and nickel, they are the members of eighth group in Mendeleev periodic table. All right. So due to these anomalies and due to these demerits, Mendeleev periodic table was cancelled, and for better study of the elements or for the better arrangement of the elements, a new concept, or you can say modern concept of the periodic table was given by an English physicist, Henri Moseley, in 1930. Children's lesson, Henri Moseley in 1930 provided modern periodic law or modern periodic table, and the main basis of Moseley periodic table or modern periodic law was atomic number. And this table is completely based on atomic number. So in 1930, Henri Moseley, an English chemist, studied that when certain metals are bombarded with high-speed electrons, then frequency of X-rays were emitted, and in all the cases he found that the frequency of the X-rays were directly proportional to the atomic number of the elements. Alright? And Henri Moseley plotted a graph between square root of frequencies and atomic number, then a straight line was obtained. Listen sincerely. Henri Moseley plotted a graph between atomic number z of the element and square root of the frequencies. Listen, and from where this frequency is coming? So just I have explained you in beginning of this point that when certain metals are bombarded with high speed electrons, then frequency of X-rays, that is nu, were obtained. And for the better study, he plotted atomic number z versus square root of the frequencies. Alright? Suppose this is your x-axis, this is your y-axis. So a straight line was observed, or a straight line was obtained. But on further investigations, he found that when square root of frequencies, as you are knowing, frequency is denoted by symbol nu, Greek letter nu, and the atomic mass A of the elements. Just point is changed. In this case, the square root of the frequencies were plotted against atomic number of the element, then a straight line was obtained. But when in further investigations Moseley plotted, that is square root of frequency versus atomic mass, that was atomic number and that is a atomic mass, then there was no any graph or there was no any straight line obtained. Then he explained that atomic number of the element is the atomic number of the element is the fundamental property of the element. Main point is, he found that on these plotting of graphs, that is atomic number of the element is the main fundamental property of the element. And in the light of these experiments or these observations, he gave an important law. That law is called modern periodic law. And the statement of this modern periodic law is based on the principle of atomic mass. And this law can be stated as, listen sincerely, the physical and chemical property of the elements are periodic function of their atomic number. Listen, according to this law, the physical and chemical property of the elements are periodic function of their atomic number. Means that elements are arranged in this table in order of increasing atomic number. Alright? Here one term is coming, periodic function. Periodic function, it is also called periodicity. Periodicity, so what it is? So listen, the repetition of similar properties of the elements. Listen, what is periodic function or periodicity? The repetition of similar properties of the elements after a certain regular interval is called periodic function or periodicity of the elements. Alright? And this, according to this modern periodic law, the elements were arranged in the increasing order of their atomic number. And on the basis of increasing order of atomic number, a table was obtained, and that table was called modern periodic table, also called long form of the periodic table. Also called long form of the periodic table, which is completely based on the increasing order of atomic number. Alright? So in modern periodic table or long form of the periodic table, there are 7 horizontal rows. Listen sincerely. There are 7 horizontal rows, and these horizontal rows were called periods. There was 7 horizontal rows, and these 7 horizontal rows were called periods and numbered as 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. Alright? Similarly, this modern periodic table or long form of the periodic table consists of 18 vertical columns, and these columns are called groups. These columns are called groups. Alright? and they are numbered as 1, 2, 3, 4 up to 18. So, modern periodic table is classified into 7 horizontal rows. These rows were known as periods, and 18 vertical columns, and these columns are known as groups. Okay, so what are periods, what are groups, and how these elements are arranged in different periods and groups. Just listen sincerely. So before starting the explanation about periods and groups, once again I want to remind you this point, periodic function, that is repetition of similar elements, the repetition of similar elements are under a regular interval is called a periodic function. The meaning behind this point is that suppose we are writing these elements in increasing atomic number. Suppose first element I taking lithium, second is beryllium, next is boron, carbon, nitrogen, oxygen, fluorine and neon. Okay student, and they are arranged in the order of increasing atomic number. So atomic number of lithium is 3, similarly 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 and 10. And next element, suppose I taking sodium, and atomic number of sodium is 11, and sodium, then magnesium, then aluminium, then silicon, then phosphorus, then sulfur, then chlorine and then argon, air. And atomic number respectively 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17 and 18. So meaning behind this point is that due to regular intervals there is a repetition of the properties of the elements. Means suppose we have written here 3, that is lithium element. So after a regular interval they will repeat the property of the, means lithium just below sodium. So properties of lithium and sodium will be the similar. This is the meaning behind this point. Means repetition of the properties of the elements under certain intervals is called a periodic function. So lithium after certain interval, means lithium after coming 4 up to 10, that is a repeating sodium. So lithium and sodium will be similar. Similarly, suppose I taking neon, neon is 10, so after certain interval coming 10 to here 17, so neon will be similar to here argon. So this is the meaning why after certain interval they will possess a similarity. Similarly, suppose I am selecting nitrogen, so nitrogen is 7, so from 7 if you are starting in increasing order of atomic number, so 7, 10 and that 11, 12, 13, 14 and 15th element will be to certain, after certain interval they will show similarity. So nitrogen and phosphorus property will be similar. So this is the meaning behind this point. So now about groups and periods, I will discuss in detail in next upcoming lecture. So till remember it. Thank you very much. Have a good day.